In this tutorial, we will create this isometric drawing in AutoCAD 2020. After completing this tutorial, you will be able to create any isometric drawing in AutoCAD very easily. To understand isometric concept completely, you are requested to watch this complete video from start to end. In this series of tutorials, we are learning AutoCAD 2020. From start to finish. Up till now we have learned 2D drawing concepts, isometric basic and 3D modeling concepts in detail. And we have also solved number of 2D drawing and 3D modeling exercises. Link to all these tutorials playlist is given in description. And if you want to learn isometric basic before solving this current exercise, then link to that tutorial is also given in description. We release new video every alternate Monday and Wednesday. To receive new video notification, please subscribe to this channel and press the bell icon. Let's start with this tutorial. Now, this drawing is in millimeter, therefore we will have to use ACAD ISO.DWT as a template. For that, click here on this arrow, then scroll down to ACAD ISO.DWT and click there. Then to check units, type UN, enter. So we will be using length type as decimal, precision is 4 digit, angle type is decimal degrees, precision is 0, and insertion scale is millimeter. So we will not make any changes to this default setting. Click on OK. Then keep this grid mode, object snap tracking and object snaps on. Then I am using endpoint, midpoint, center, quadrant and intersection object snaps. Click outside. Then to switch to isometric mode, click here on isometric drafting. Command name is ISO draft. Click. So here isometric drafting is on. Right now left plane is activated. If you have different plane, you can activate your desired plane by clicking here on this arrow. And from here you can select your desired plane. So right now I have selected this isoplane left. So in this object, at first we will create this rectangle of 75 by 9 sides. Click here on line, then specify first point here, make ortho on, take your cursor on this side, specify length of 75, enter. Then zoom there, pan it, take your cursor on this side, specify height of 9, enter. Take your cursor to this point, don't click there and take it away. As our object snap tracking is on, so it will track that point, click there and click on this end point. Press enter. So here this rectangle is ready. Then next is to create this circular portion. Radius of this circle is 15 and radius of this outside circle is 15 plus 8, that is 23. And center of this circle is located at the height of 40 from this horizontal line. So to locate that center, at first we will create one line. Click on line, click on this midpoint. Take your cursor on this side, specify height of 40, enter, enter to stop line command. Pan it below. Then to create isometric circle, you will have to use ellipse command. So take your cursor to this ellipse command and click here on this arrow. For isocircle, you will have to use this axis end command. Don't click on this center, click on axis end. Then click on isocircle, Then specify center point of isocircle. Click on this endpoint, take your cursor away, specify radius of 15, enter. Again enter to repeat last command, click on isocircle. Click on this endpoint, take your cursor away, specify radius of 23, enter. Then next is this portion, this thickness is 9, that means gap between this center line and this vertical line will be 4.5. So to create this line, we will use copy command. Click on copy, select this line, enter, specify base point here. Take your cursor on this side, ensure that your ortho mode is on. Specify gap of 4.5, enter. Take your cursor on this side, again specify 4.5, enter. Then press enter to stop copy command. Then we will create one line here. For that you can also type L, enter. Then to catch this point, take your cursor to this endpoint and take it away. And click here on this intersection point. Then take your cursor on this side and click. Press enter. Then to remove unwanted objects, type TR for trim. Press enter, enter, and remove unwanted objects. Then press enter. To remove this line, type E. Enter, select this line, enter. So this portion is ready. Then we will have to copy this portion at the gap of 52. So basically we will have to copy this line, this arc, line, this arc, and this complete portion. That means this side portion is not required because it will not be visible. Click on copy, then select this portion, and this vertical line will also required. Press enter, click on this endpoint. Now I want to take my cursor on this side, but right now my left plane is activated, therefore this cursor is not going on this side. So to change plane, you can use F5 on keyboard as a shortcut key. Or you can also use Ctrl E, and if you want to use from screen, then you will have to click here on this arrow and choose your required plane. So I want to go on the right side, so I will choose this isoplane right. Then take your cursor on this side, specify gap of 52, enter. Then press enter to stop copy command. Then we will create connecting line. For that type L, enter, click on this endpoint and this endpoint, press enter, then again copy, CO, enter, select this line, enter, then base point will be this endpoint and second point will be this endpoint, select all these points, so those connecting lines will be created. Make ortho off. So that it will be visualized correctly. Click. Then one more line will be required from this quadrant point. So don't click on this midpoint. Click on this quadrant point. So quadrant point will be correct. Press enter. Then remove this unwanted portion. For that type TR for trim. Press enter. Enter. And remove these unwanted objects. Zoom there. Click. And enter. To stop trim command. Then one line will be required here. For that again L, enter, click at this endpoint, take your cursor inside and click here at intersection point. Press enter. Then next is to create this rib of 8 thickness. Again this shape can be copied from this side. Before that we will create one line here. And we will copy it at the distance of 4 on either side. Type L, enter, click on this midpoint and this midpoint. Press enter, type CO, enter, select this line, enter, specify base point here, make ortho on, take your cursor on this side, specify 4, enter, again take your cursor on this side, pan it, take your cursor on this side, specify 4, enter, and enter to stop copy command. Then we will copy this portion. For that again type CO, enter, select this object, press enter, click on this endpoint and this endpoint, press enter. Then to remove unwanted objects, for that type TR, enter, again enter to select all objects as a cutting edge and remove unwanted objects. So I will not require these objects because these objects will be invisible. So we will remove them. Here it is created perfectly. Press enter, then type E, enter, and remove these objects, enter. So this object is perfectly ready. So that's all. In the next part, we will create and apply layers and apply dimensions. Thanks for watching. We will again meet in next tutorial and learn about applying layers and dimensions.